Hallo und willkommen zu another Replaycast. And today I'm gonna feature Wavetti from our clan Wargaming Pay to Win in his Charmatel. And this is, first of all, a really awesome replay. And the other thing is, finally, a ship that is rarely featured, but in my opinion deserves to be played a bit more. And it's one of the really good ships in the French cruiser line, in my opinion. Why is that? Well, it has a good rate of fire. Oh, give me a sec. Okay, just checking the speed of the replay. Has a really good rate of fire of I think it's 9 point something or 10 seconds with the reload. Much? No, it doesn't have the access to the reload much. It's 10 seconds, so it's pretty good. It has 9 203mm guns, and yeah. On top, speed boost, decent AA, good torp angles, 9 km torps. Just what you want to have. It's such a versatile ship, in my opinion. It's not so limited to sitting back and burning down battleships. It can play also an aggressive role, it need be. Not in the early game, but later on. And Wavetti is demonstrating here almost everything of it. So, we are playing on Trident, and we are playing in the favorable matchmaking for a TA ship, I have to admit here, but still, what he pulls off is really nice, and of course some RNG luck as well, but still, it's nice to see such a good replay, and there are some certain things I watched it before, and some things I want to highlight, which are really well played, in my opinion. All right, so yeah, he's just doing some normal shenanigans, setting fires here, there, right, left, and center, which is the job of the French cruisers, anyways. Staying in the mid to long range distance, also what you wanted. Do most of the time in the French cruisers, and from there work on your way and try to burn down whatever comes into your way. Doesn't mean you don't need to use AP on the ship, because AP is also really, really potent. Thing is, in tier 6 matchmaking, it's of course doing it better, because in this case the armor isn't that strong, your fire chance is going up significantly because the, how can I say it? Normally if you face higher tiers, then your fire chance gets a bit reduced by the tier factor, let's call it like this. And of course in this case, it's definitely a bit stronger, and it's an excellent fire starter. With this rate of fire and base fire chance, he's doing quite well job, or the ship in general. So now I have normal speed, right? No, this is normal speed. Yeah, sorry that I'm playing around. I'm always a bit unsure, but okay. So he almost cleared the whole right flank here for himself. He's also in the division with the Kagero, Barter, who's trying to gain some caps at the same time. While he is like cleaning up this flank completely, this Eagle is doing some massive mistake, doesn't smoke up. For whatever reasons, tries to go dark, but then he should have turned out instead of turning in, because this is now the death sentence for him. This is like easy game now to get control over this area. And there the Aigle goes. And what I really found impressive is his awareness, first of all. His aim is really on point, and how he's playing around with the ship in general is like awesome, absolutely awesome. I was at a point when I was like thinking, wow, if I would always pay that attention to what I'm doing, then I would be would maybe have also more of these games. So that was quite impressive, as I said. Sadly, his teammate Barter goes down. He got radared by this. This is always such a fun stuff if one guy is just YOLOing in like this Cleveland, just for the sake of killing a DD, but he's going to get killed in return, so not really a big fan of this. You're ruining your own game and you're ruining the game of someone else for actually no positive outcome. Sometimes it can be worth doing it, but yeah. Not all this. So now we come to a part where I'm really, or was really impressed by his play, and it shows you how you should play cruisers. So he's facing a Colorado. First, he's in a distance like where he can just shoot shots. I mean, of course, if you face someone who knows how to aim with a BB, it's a bit more dangerous. But first of all, his concealment value is 10.5. Normally you want to not engage with the cruiser, but in this case he's showing how you can do it if you want to do it. So he's doing the usual fire target shenanigans, avoiding shots. Okay, let's be honest, this Colorado is not the best at aiming as well, so that's also the point. He has issues to estimate the speed and so on, and Bavetti is doing a great job in varying his speed, his direction. He also turns in left now to not to show broadside, but not to end up on the edge. And right now he is like hanging in a bit by slowing down. So I mean, this pattern is, to someone who is a bit experienced, pretty obvious, and you can estimate it at some point, but it's really hard. If I would be that Colorado, I wouldn't turn away, honestly. I would slow down and let him come closer. But Vavetti is doing a great job, but not going too close. So he always, in case he gets frontal citadel, which is highly also possible with the Colorado, since he has 406mm guns, that he can still disengage into safety. Also, you know, maybe you noted, the French cruisers have all spaced armor, and he's using his armor plate and baits the shots of the Colorado to shoot exactly that. And that's why he gets even bounces and doesn't get penetrated at all. Nier is just speeding up again, bounces, or an overpen it was. So, he's doing quite a good job. So now he's a bit close, but I think at that point he doesn't fear the Colorado anymore, because he lost already so much HP, so damage con. The only thing he has to worry about is maybe one of the other battleships, but that's a different story. They are so far off. Seem to have no interest in him, so... And this Colorado player is, I would say, inexperienced. That's why he's not hitting at all, more or less. And yeah, Bavetti is already in 3 kills so far, high caliber, and that's number 4, probably getting an arsonist as well, yep. Very impressive play, I like it. I mean, you can't do it against tier 10 battleships, let's be honest, but against his lower tier battleships, maybe same tier, but same tier is already a bit iffy. You can pull something like this off. So he's going for the next target, which is the Bismarck, probably the biggest threat here for him. Yeah, and this guy is now already no big threat anymore because one damage con, you don't want to do this. This is the damage con won't fire. This is such a crucial mistake. You shouldn't do it in a battleship, especially not against ships like that have such a base DPM and fire chance like Charmatel. Now he has to suffer the fires at all costs, and yeah, instead of going ham and going a bit aggressive, well, okay. I mean, he could go aggressive in my opinion. If he faces Vavetti, that's the real, or the only thing that really hurts him. The Bayern, the Colorado, they can't overpen him from the front. The Lyon is down, more or less, so yeah. Could have saved for more or less a lot of HP, but it's a typical player that is either unexperienced or, let's face it, kind of a pussy, because if you're in a top tier battleship, you want to have influence on the game. This guy is showing that he has clearly no clue what is having influence on the game, and his priority target should be Vavetti in Charmatel. I mean, 14.7 kilometer is not that far off. Of course, Vavetti is not an easy target since he's using the speed boost to like accelerate quickly from stationary positions, like you see right now, and even reversing, as you see right now, all doable with the thanks to the French speed boost. Yeah, New Mexico, somewhere over the ocean. I mean, these battleships on the enemy team are quite special. Yeah, there we go, the Wither Reward. Don't know. They are playing way too far back, way too passive, and I think that's probably costing the enemy team, yeah, a win or whatever you want to call it, at least a lot of influence. If your battleships are sitting that far behind, then nothing you can do about it. So the Cleveland, next target, he switches to AP. As I said, it's a really potent AP. Make sure that he's shooting over the island and he's even scoring a citadel, and the Bayern is finishing the Cleveland off. And now he's doing what you always do in the French cruiser, you just harass the battleships, and yeah, I mean, he's even doing it out of stealth because he has cover from the terrain. And now he's spotted by the New Mexico, but not anymore. And he is walking his, or sailing his way to the cap. The only thing he needs to be aware of, not ending in a crossfire. Last known for position from the Bismarck is not the most optimal one for him. But it seems as if the enemy battleships have no eyes for him, so. Okay, at the moment they can't because it was unspotted, but still. Never underestimate a good played cruiser, and that's what battleships are doing here. They are focusing hard on the Bayern, which is okay, I would say, because he's low HP, but I mean, all the time, I think he upset the battleships so much at some point that they don't even want to shoot him anymore, just by juking the shots and so on. And now he's spreading just fires on all the ships, which is fine. Set a fire on that one, another one on the other one, so they aren't forced to use damage con that often. And yeah, he's already at 225,000 damage, which is like crazy. I think my highest game in the Charmatel is like 160, 170 or something. But there is a reason I like to play it in the, for example, tier 8 competitive meta. It really had a place there. Yeah, nice, Sirius, this armor belt again. That's why he got all, or the Neon Bones completely off. And he's always trying to make them shoot into the armor belt. Yeah. But yeah, relating to the, it's such a strong ship in my opinion, one of the strongest tier 8 cruisers. There was a reason only Atago, Kutuzov and Shah Martel had a place at some point in the tier 8 meta. And here he fucked up the first time in the whole game. Showed a bit too much broadsides, and that were perfect shots by the Lyon, I would say. And he receives the Kraken award, which is also great. For the upcoming ranked season, I can still highly recommend this ship if you like the French cruiser line. This is a really potent ship, and well played, it's devastating and deadly. I think when there was the last only tier 8 season, I played almost completely or exclusively Shah Martel, and was really successful with it. So the first part of the upcoming season will be tier 8, and then it will split up to tier 10 if I'm not mistaken. So this is one of the ships you can definitely go for as a cruiser player. Yeah, and now it's easy game for him. Finish off the Bismarck and takes down his 6th kill. And oh boy, what a game. 250,000 damage game in a tier 6 matchmaking, so you can imagine the work he did. Impressive, just impressive. 6 kills, 5 citadels, 10 base resets. Yeah, I think the awards speak for itself. Confederate, high caliber, 2 times arsonist, Kraken, and Witherer. Yeah, that's basically Shah Martel in a nutshell in a good game, if you know how to play it. And I think Vavetti clearly showed how you have to play it. Of course, you can't sit that close in a tier 10 matchmaking. You have to play a bit more careful, maybe hug islands in the beginning, because tier 10 matchmaking is still a different story. But I think Shah Martel can do quite okay in a tier 10 matchmaking. The thing I'm really not happy about it is that they that Wargame decided to put a reload booster also for the Shah Martel. I think the base reload on the Shah Martel or also the St. Louis is good enough that there is no necessity to implement that consumable. I think both of the ships are doing fine. For the Henri the Fourth, I think it's okay and it's definitely fun. But for these two cruisers, it's, I think, not mandatory. They are all both doing already pretty good. And if people don't like to play them, that's a different story, but it's definitely not the ship, in my opinion. Yeah. Okay, a few words to that. Well, let's go quickly over the base XP, which is also really impressive. 3,000 base XP in a tier 8 to tier 6 matchmaking is... and if you... saw it, I mean, there were... Yeah, I can't say. Okay, it was really balanced, so... He made some damage on each of the ships, also on the Clevelands, for example, and... he killed one DD, so of course there's some influence. Don't know if he even kept, I think he didn't. So that can be excluded, so that's a still really impressive number of base XP. In a tier 6 to tier 8 matchmaking, in my opinion. And yeah, well deserved, in my opinion. The play was, except for one fuck up where he was a bit sloppy, but that's, I mean, that can happen to all of us. And I think that can't be criticized too much because he showed off a lot of good plays before. And then, detailed overview. I think almost every ship on the enemy team got hit once by him. At least I had the feeling. Yeah, 1.2 potential damage. As I said, at some point I think the enemies give up or they were for them better opportunities to shoot other targets, so nothing to criticize. If it would have been a bit more closer, then probably this potential damage would have risen a bit higher. Apart from that, of course, HE is your bread and butter. But AP is, as I said, also not to underestimate. And on top, the fire chance. 23 fires, okay, this is not normal, I would say. That's what I mean. It's also a bit RNG-based sometimes. 95,000 fire damage tells also a story, though. All right, yeah. Thanks, Vavetti, for sending this in. This was really impressive and enjoyable to watch and to commentate on. For all those out there who liked it as well and aren't bothered by my interruptions because I didn't know or need to, or I didn't know what to say or need to find words to say it. Yeah, give it a like. Just for the sake of Bavetti's gameplay, it's already okay. And yeah, that's it for me for today. And yeah, see you next time and bye bye.